Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. Today's topic for discussion will be capitalistic economy. So let's proceed. So what is capitalistic economy? In general terms, capitalistic economy means free economy. Economy which is not regulated by the government, where anyone can have any factor of production, anyone can own any factor of production. The prices are decided by the price mechanism, that is by the supply and demand, no government intervention. So that economy is called capitalistic economy. Let's read. Capitalistic economy is an economic system in which private individuals or businesses own capital goods. So any individual, any business can have the capital goods. Government will not say that you cannot invest in this particular business or you cannot do this particular economic activity. You are free to own goods and you are free to do any economic activity. The production of goods and services is based on supply and demand in the general market, known as market economy. So the price is not decided by the government, like in controlled or in the planned economy. Government sometimes decide the basic price, that is a minimum price. Okay, it decide the support price. But in capitalistic economy, there is no support price, there is no minimum price. Price is generally decided by the supply and demand. So today, most countries practice a mixed capitalist economy, like pure capitalistic economy. There is no country which follows a pure economic capitalistic economy. There is some form of government intervention, some form of central planning. So right now, no such country. But if you say like the countries which follow kind of capitalistic economy are like Russia, like the US, like Hong Kong. These are the countries which follow the capitalistic system. So the first characteristic of a capitalistic economy is that right to private property. So any individual in a capitalistic economy can have any type of capital goods, plus they can use that capital goods in any manner they like. Suppose someone wants to open a wine shop, so they can use that particular land to open the wine shop. Government will have no interference. But in planned economy, sometimes we know that government don't want to open such kind of shops in particular areas because that is not good for the society. But in the capitalist economy, there is no restriction. You can have any capital goods and you can use them in any manner you like. Second thing, that this is a demerit, that there is no control. But second profit thing, the merit thing is that if there is a private ownership on capital goods, then the person will try to maximum utilize it. They will try to reduce the wastage and they will try to have the maximum benefit they can get from that private property. So it increases the benefits. So the first characteristic of the capitalistic economy is right to have the private property. Now the second one is free enterprise. Free enterprise means that any individual is free to engage in any economic activity. You can choose any economic activity you want, like the example I given for the land to open the wine shop. So if you want to do the wine business, you are free to do. Government will not stop you on any grounds. So free enterprise, you are free to do any kind of economic activity. So for example, I've written, the producer is free to set up any type of firm and produce any type of goods or services, and the consumer are free to utilize any kind of resources. So you have freedom of any form of organization you want to set up, any form of economic activity you want to have, and any kind of consumption you want to do. So the next characteristic for the capitalist economy is that freedom of economic choice. What does freedom of economic choice means? It means anybody, whether it be a producer or a consumer or an investor or anybody in the society, are free to make their own economic decisions. Like if it is a producer, he can make any product he wants, he can buy any raw material he wants, he can start any form of organization he wants. There is no government intervention. Same goes for the consumer. They can buy any product they want, the price which is decided by the price mechanism. There is no government intervention regarding the price or the product which the consumer can buy. Same for the investors. Investors can invest in any projects they want, and the rate of interest which is generally decided by the market forces. So anybody in the society can make any economic decision
freely without intervention of the government. Now, the next characteristic, which is the basic and the most important characteristic, is the profit motive. Capitalistic economy is run by the profit motive. Whoever it is, whether a producer or a consumer, both wants to maximize their profits. So what does producer want? They want that the factors of production, that is their resources, are utilized fully in a way which can increase their profit. They want to produce only those products which the consumers will buy. They know that the consumers will buy, and the consumers try to increase their profit by buying those products from the market which they really need, which they really want, at the prices which is generally decided by both the demand and the supply. So both of them in a capitalist economy will try to increase their profits, and thus it is a benefit for the society because there will be less wastages as everyone is trying to increase their profits. But yep, it will increase the competition, but that is fair. So the next characteristic comes, that is consumer sovereignty. Consumer sovereignty means that consumers are the deciding force for the capitalistic economy. How? Because the consumer decides what they want to buy. So on the basis of the demand, the producers will try to produce that product because they want to maximize their profit. And how can they maximize their profit? By selling that product which has a good demand in the society, which has a good demand by the consumers. So consumers are the basic driving force to run the capitalistic economy. All depends on the consumer, what they want to buy, because the producer is going to produce only those products which are required in the market, which will be fast selling product. Now the next is competition. Competition is another important factor in the capitalistic economy. This is because first thing, that producer wants to maximize their profit, and second thing, all the producers will try to maximize their profits, and so they will be producing the same kind of product or the similar kind of product so that the consumers can buy their product, and this thing creates a competition in the society or in the economics. But sometimes the competition is good. Why? Because when there is a competition in the market, suppose the consumer wants to buy the bread. So there are so many options, so many brands which are selling the bread. So if they want that their bread should sell faster than the producer, they will try to keep their bread price down and the quality up. So the consumer prefers their product instead of other competitors' product. So sometimes competition is good for the economy.
Now the last characteristic which you all are aware is that there is no government interference in the capitalistic economy. Though there is no pure form of capitalistic economy right now in any of the countries, but if there is a pure form of capitalist economy, then there will be no intervention. There will be no central planning, just like the planning which generally the governments do, the central planning, the central budget, the fiscal policies. There will be nothing like that, because every decision will be taken by the market forces freely without government intervention. Second, all the economic decisions in the capitalistic economy are driven by the self-interest and the price mechanism. There is no role of government in all this. Now there's an example. Government does not prohibit the private property. That is government in a capitalist economy, you all know that we can buy the private property. Anybody can own any kind of property. There is no government interference. Then government does not decide the wages and salary like in our government. Generally the mixed economy, what happened? The government decide the basic minimum price which we have to pay to the producers, or which the producers will get for their product. But in government economy, there is no support system like this. There will be no support prices. There will be no minimum prices. But generally for the public utilities under capitalistic economy also, there is some form of government regulation. Otherwise, there is no government interference in a purest form of capitalistic economy. I hope guys you like this video, you understand that what is capitalistic economy and what are its characteristics. These characteristics are the basic for the capitalist economy, and they can be a merit to the capitalistic economy or they can be a demerit. So the merit and demerit all depends on the characteristics of the capitalistic economy itself. If you have any questions, any queries, please leave a comment. Please let me know. I'll try to solve your problem. And if you like my channel, if you like my videos, please subscribe with your friends and please subscribe my channel. and follow me on the Instagram also. Bye bye, see you in the next video.